Class. So basically, in the last lecture, we have started with the architecture of 8051. So we'll just take a quick overview regarding what was it taken in the architecture. Okay. So module 2 में हमने start क्या किया था? हमने features of 8051 पढ़ा. उसके बाद हमने pin diagram देखा. Pin diagram के बाद the next topic that we have covered was called as architecture of 8051. Okay. So in 8051 we have defined the 8051 जो architecture है आपका. It has basically three parts. The first part is called as the processor part. The second part is called as the memory part. And the third part is basically called as IO ports part. Okay. So ये तीनों part को हमने अलग-अलग specify किया है. Okay. So when we go to the first part, which is called as the processor. So processor के अंदर 8051 के पास ALU होता है. इस ALU पे जो size है, that is basically a 8-bit ALU. Okay. So ये ALU क्या करेगा? It will perform two operation, which is arithmetic operation or logical operation. Okay. So whenever it want to perform arithmetic and logical operation, it would require certain operands in on which it has to perform the operation. So that operands would be provided by the most special registers, which are called as accumulator register and a B register. So we have got two register. One is called as A register and other is called as a B register. These two registers are very important and the most common register that we generally use for performing the every operation. So these two registers are generally 8-bit registers. Okay, why 8-bit register? Because 8051 is nothing but it is an 8-bit microcontroller. So it performs operation onto 8-bit of data. So that is why we have got A, B, which are the two registers who will be storing the data into it. So the data hoga, that would be again 8-bit data. So 8-bit ke data ko agar aapko store karna, to you naturally require an 8-bit register. That is why we have got A, B register. So this AB register will provide the operand. Okay. So ye operand jo hoga ALU perform karega and it would generate the result. So result would be either stored in A if it is a source register. Okay. Or agar B source hoga, to B ke paas generally result hoga. Okay. But generally it is there with the accumulator. Then we have got a PSW register as well. So PSW is nothing but it is a program status word. Okay, so the work of the program status word is that basically it is a register which will hold the status of every instruction. Okay, so whatever instruction which has been performed, uska jo status hoga, that would be stored into the program status word. So what do you mean by status? Status means the carry bit that has been generated, the auxiliary carry that has been generated, parity, etc. So that is all information that will be stored into the program status board. Apart from these registers, we have got two more registers, but these two more registers will not store data. They will store the address. Okay. So for storing the address, we will be having two registers. One will be called as a PC and other would be called as a DPTR. So since address is of 16 bit, naturally these two registers, which will be PC and DPTR, will be obviously would be of size 16 bit. Okay. So PC would hold the address of the next instruction, whereas DPTR would hold the address of DPTR would point towards data. So DPTR would point toward the data. So basically it would have the address of the data. So ये दोनों register के पास basically address होता है, okay? So ये जो address होगा, ये आप address bus पे डालोगे, okay? So address जो है आपका basically दो category में आता है, either it can be a 8-bit address or it can be a 16-bit address, okay? So it depends on which memory you're being connected. So that is all related to the processor part. Now we'll go to the memory part. So 8051 basically has how many types of memory? 8051 has how many types of memory?
Four types of memory,
which are internal RAM, internal ROM, external RAM, and external ROM. Okay, so since we are talking about the architecture of 8051, we are talking about the overall architecture of 8051. In that case, we'll be having only two memory, which is the internal RAM and internal ROM. So internal RAM and internal ROM, internal RAM has a size of 128 byte, whereas internal ROM has a size of 4 kilobyte. Okay, so that are the sizes of internal RAM and internal ROM. So because of these sizes, you will be able to identify the size of the address bus that is being supported. So since internal RAM ka jo size hai, internal RAM ka size is 128 byte. So naturally, usko address jo lagega, that is 7 bit. But because computer supports a number which is in power of 2, so 7 jo hai, that is not a power of 2, so you need to add an extra 0 to it. So iske liye aap ek bit extra add karte ho. So that is why the address of internal RAM would be 8 bit. Whereas in the case of internal ROM, we require the size of the internal ROM is 4 kilobyte. So 4 kilobyte के लिए जो एड्रेस का स्पेस लगेगा, दैट एड्रेस का साइज इज 12 byte. अगेन 12 byte इज नॉट अ पावर ऑफ टू, सो वी विल हैव टू एड एक्स्ट्रा 4 जीरोस टू इट, व्हिच विल मेक द एड्रेस ऑफ 16 bit. सो दो एड्रेस है हमारे पास, वन इज कॉल्ड एज 8 bit एड्रेस, अदर विल बी कॉल्ड एज 16 bit एड्रेस. सो इन ऑर्डर टू पास दिस एड्रेस वी वुड बी हैविंग टू डिफरेंट बसेस, वन वुड बी कॉल्ड एज 8 bit बस एंड अदर वुड बी कॉल्ड एज 16 bit एड्रेस बस. ओके, सो व्हिच यू कैन सी इन द डायग्राम विद द हेल्प ऑफ अ व्हाइट. White will be the bus which carries 8-bit address, whereas we have got a yellow bus. That yellow bus will be carrying the address which has a size of 16-bit. Okay, so that is all related to the memory part. Now we'll go to the input-output ports part. So input-output ports, basically 8051 has how many ports? How many ports it has?
Four.
Which are P0, P1,
P0 to P3.
P3. So it has P0, P1, P2, P3. Okay. So these ports will generally will take the input or it will display the output. But apart from taking the input and displaying the output, it has some additional functionality to it. So port 0, the additional functionality is that it can also be connected to the external devices with इसके ऊपर आप address और data bus भी आप put कर सकते हो, which are multiplexed together. So that is the additional functionality. Port 1 does not have any additional functionality. It is generally used for the input output ports. Port 2 may basically jo aapka higher address hoga wo aap additional functionality mein wahan pe aap higher address pass kar sakte ho. At port 3 mein kuch special functionality hota hai, jaise ki aapka timer, jaise ki aapka interrupt, jaise ki serial port communication, ye sab karne ke liye aapko port 3 ki utilization hoga. So these ports in architecture, apart from these ports, in order to make them as port, we have to add extra component. That extra component is called as a latch. So latch is nothing but it is a component which will basically store the value. Okay, so whenever you want to connect to some input output port, so whatever the value which has to be displayed on the port or which has to be taken into the port, that needs to be stored somewhere. Okay, so that storing would be done by a component which is called as a latch. Okay, so that is all related to the input output ports. Next we have a component which is called as a timing and control circuit. Timing and control circuit is the overall brain of the 8051 microcontroller. So timing and control circuit mein basically we have got pins such as crystal 1 and crystal 2, which will generally provide the clock pulse to all the respective component of 8051. Then we have got a reset which will perform the reset operation. Then we have got ALE which stands for address latch enable. So whether port 0 pe address hai ki data hai, so that would be identified by the ALE pin. Then we have got PSEN bar, then we have got EA bar, VCC and VSS. Generally these function has been already been covered in the pin diagram. So that is all related to architecture of 8051. I hope it is clear to you. Is it clear?
Yes.
Does anybody has any doubt in it? Because the topic is important. ये पूछा जाता है, अगर किसी को doubt है वो अभी पूछ लो, नहीं तो आगे बढ़ते हैं. Should I move forward or do you want me to ask? Does anybody has any doubt? Should I move forward?
Yes.
Okay. Sir. So is the white background is good or if the black background is okay to you? Black चलेगा आपको?
Black.
Okay.
Black.
So the next topic that we'll be discussing will be called as PSW. Okay, so write down the next topic, all of you. The next topic that we have is called as PSW. PSW का full form है program status word. So please write down the topic name as program status word. Okay, so program status word क्या है? This is nothing but a register. Okay, so ये register का size कितना होगा? Because generally 8051 is a 8-bit processor, so इसके अंदर सारे के सारे रजिस्टर जो हैं ज़्यादातर वो 8-bit के होंगे. सिवाय two register which are of 16-bit. One is called as a DPTR and second one is called as a PC. So ये दोनों because they generally hold the address. Address का size is 16-bit. इसके लिए ये दो register खाली ऐसे दो register हैं जिसके पास 16-bit का size होगा. बाकी सारे register जो होंगे वो 8-bit के होंगे. So PSW का size कितना होगा? What would be the size of PSW? Size of PSW would be 8-bit. Okay, so please draw the diagram. So this is the architecture that we have. This is the internal of a PSW register. So we have got 8 bits into it. The first the first compartment of the PSW register would be called as CY. CY stand for, can anybody have any wild guess? CY can be called as
carry.
The second one is called as AC. AC, any wild guess for AC?
Auxiliary carry.
This is a new one, which is called as FO. Ye koi naya hai. It is not, you have studied right now till now. Then we have got another bit, which is called as RS1. We have got another bit, which is called as RS0. Then we have OVR. Can anybody have a wild guess over here? OVR stand for?
Overflow.
OVR stand for overflow. Then we have X. X means? Don't care. Okay. So it does not have any implication. So aap yahan pe 0 dalo, 1 dalo, it does not. It has not been reserved actually. So ye don't care. It can be 0, it can be 1, whatever it can be. Okay. So yahan pe don't care. Then we have the last flag, which will be called as P. So P stand for?
Parity.
Okay. So we'll try to understand the first one. The first one is called as carry. So please write down in your notes. The first one is called as a carry flag. So carry flag ka matlab kya hota hai? What do you mean by carry flag? Carry flag, when will carry flag will become 1 and when it will become 0? When it will become 1?
When carry is generated, it will become 1.
So what do you mean carry is generated? Carry is generated means when there is a carry which is generated out of LSB or MSB?
MSB.
So if there is a carry which is generated out of MSB, in that case the carry flag will be made as 1. Else, if there is no carry out of MSB, in that case it would be 0. Okay. So for example, agar mere paas, let's say we have got a number. I've got a number ka maan lo. I will go to the next slide. Example ke liye. So next slide, let's say agar mere paas ek number hai which is FF. Okay. FF. I want to represent in binary. FFH. I want to represent in binary. How to represent FFH in binary? 1, 1, 1, 1. And F can be represented as 1, 1, 1, 1. Okay, so agar FFH ko main 0, 1, H ke sath add karta hu, okay, so what would be the output that I can get? So 0 can be represented as 4 zeros and 1 can be represented as 0, 0, 0, 1. I want to perform the add operation. So kya hoga? 1 plus 1 would be
0.
0, carry 1, again 0, carry 1, 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 0, and last we have a carry. So if there is a MSB which is generated, if there is a carry which is generated out of the MSB, then it will be called as a carry. Okay. So agar carry hua, in that case the carry flag will be made as 1. So in this case, carry flag kya hoga? Will it be made as 1 or it will be made as 0?
1.
So that is the example that you can write down. So carry flag ka matlab kya hoga? Agar I want to perform any operation, if that operation on being performed, if the result generates MSB has a carry which has been generated out of it, in that case the carry flag will be made as 1. Okay, is it clear? Carry flag samajh mein aaya? Then we have the next flag, which is called as auxiliary carry flag. Auxiliary carry flag ka matlab kya hoga? If there is a carry generated, carry agar generate hoga kahan se?
Nibble or byte.
Yeah. So if there is a carry which is generated out of nibble, over here there is no concept of byte because 8086 mein there was a concept of byte or word. Because wo processor jo tha wo 16 bit ka tha. यहाँ पे आपका 8 बिट का ही है, सो इसका एग्जैक्टली हाफ इज बेसिकली निबल. सो देयर इफ देयर इज अ कैरी जनरेटेड आउट ऑफ द निबल, निबल का मतलब 4 बिट. अगर 4 बिट पे जो आपका बेसिकली डेटा होगा उसके बाद अगर आपका बेसिकली 4th बिट से अगर आपका कैरी जनरेट होता है, इन दैट केस द ऑक्सिलरी कैरी विल बी मेड एज 1. एल्स इफ देयर इज नो कैरी व्हिच इज जनरेटेड आउट ऑफ द लोअर निबल, In that case, it would be 0. The auxiliary carry will be made as 0. So no carry out of the lower navel. In that case, it would be made at 0. Okay, so this nibble that we are talking about, these are lower nibble. Okay, so just remember that. So example, again, the same example you can take over here. So this is called as the lower nibble. So if you perform the operation on the lower nibble, so if you can see over here, there is a MSP which is generated out of the lower nibble. Okay, so lower nibble ke pass, yani lower nibble ka matlab, nibble is nothing but it is half of a pipe. Okay, so if you guys remember, generally, normal person take a bite, so that bite is generally a full bite, which is 8-bit in size, and kids generally take or they take a nibble of food. So nibble is nothing but exactly half of a bite. So 4-bit ko basically we call it as a nibble. Okay, so agar aap dekhoge, so ek bite ke andar we have got two nibbles. One is called as a lower nibble, other is called as a higher nibble. So agar lower nibble jo hai aapka, wo operation perform hone ke baad, if it generates a carry, in that case, that carry would be called as a auxiliary carry. Is it clear? Is auxiliary carry flag clear to you?
Yes, sir.
So it is already been covered, so I don't think so there would be some doubt in it. Problem aega FO, RS1 or RS0 mein. Baki sab already cover hai, but still we'll just try to cover it. Okay, so ye toh ho gaya. Now we'll go to the next one, which is called as a P. Okay, FO. RS1, RS0 ka hum log aaram se jaate hain, but we'll cover what has been already been covered. Okay, so next is parity. Okay, so parity ka matlab kya hoga? What is parity? What it will generate? Parity flag kya hoga?
It counts the number of ones in the result.
It's, okay, so basically it counts the number of ones in the result. So let's assume ki mera result jo hai, maan lo koi operation ke baad my result that I've generated is 0 1 1 0 0 1 0 1. Okay, this is the result that I have got after performing the operation. Okay, so how many ones it has? How many number of ones it has? Number of ones kya hoga? Number of ones will be, how many number of ones it has? It has 4 ones. Okay, 1 2 3 and 4. So it has got 4 number of ones. Okay, so this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4. Okay, so since we just need to count the number of ones, it will just parity bit kya karega, it will just count the number of ones. Agar number of ones jo hai aapka agar even hoga, okay, if the number of ones is even, in that case the parity flag will be made as 0. Okay, so in case of even, since 4 is even, in that case the parity flag will be made as 0. If it is odd, in that case the parity flag will be made as 1. Okay, so agar maan lo ye 1 ki jagah pe, if it would have been 0, okay, ab ye 0 hota, in that case number of ones will be 3. So in this case the parity flag will be made as 1. Is it clear? Is the concept clear?
Yes.
So parity flag will do what? It will check or it will count the number of ones. If the number of ones is even, in that case the parity flag will be made as 0. If the number of ones will be odd, in that case parity flag will be 1. Okay, so jab 3 hoga to ye odd ho jayega, to parity flag 1 ho jayega. Jab 4 hoga ya 2 hoga ya 6 hoga ya 8 hoga, in that case parity flag will be made as 0. Okay, tell me this situation. 0 0 0 0 agar aapka output kuch aisa aata hai, what would be the parity? Iske liye parity kya hoga? Number of ones kitne hai? 0
0 even.
Parity kya hoga?
Zero.
Parity would be 0, because 0 is generally considered as an even number. So even my parity would be taken as 0. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Next, so I will just write down, it is called as a parity flag. So parity flag ka matlab kya hoga? If it is, it will be made as 1 when it is odd. It will be made as 0 when it will be made as even, when the parity will be even. Okay, so that is related to parity. X ka matlab kya hai? What do you mean by X? It is don't care. Okay, so don't care, so it does not, you do not have to care about it. Okay, so it can be 0, it can be 1, so whatever value you can give it, you can use it for your own purpose. Basically ye basically flag ya koi status ye store nahi karega, it is not been defined, so it can be anything. Okay, so basically you write down over there, it don't care. Okay, so it does not have any functionality. Fine with that? Next we have the next flag, which is called as overflow flag. Okay, overflow flag. Okay, so does anybody remember what is overflow flag? Overflow flag पता है आप सबको? याद है कि वापस स्टार्ट करना पड़ेगा? Should I explain it again?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So basically overflow flag क्या होता है? I will just take a new slide again. So overflow का मतलब क्या होता है? Overflow basically कब होता है? Basically when we start with defining with two types of numbers. Okay. अगर आप normal जो number अब तक पढ़ रहे थे, those are called as unsigned numbers. But when we talk about signed numbers, in that case there is a condition of overflow. Okay. So basically अगर आप number system अगर आप देखते हो, तो number system जो आपका होता है, वो basically दो part में divide होता है. एक को बोला जाता है signed numbers. और एक को बोला जाता है unsigned number. So what is unsigned number? Can anybody tell me what is unsigned number? Unsigned number का मतलब क्या होता है?
Positive.
Positive number. Basically, it will hold only the magnitude. It will not have any sign. So 40 is unsigned number. 45 is an unsigned number. So generally, ये जो है positive यानी magnitude होता है इसके बाद. इसके बाद sign नहीं होता है. Whereas in case of signed numbers में क्या होगा basically? It would be minus 40, plus 40, okay, minus 45, okay. So these are the number which holds the sign plus the magnitude. Those number will be called as a signed numbers, okay. So जब तक आप unsigned number पे work कर रहे हो, okay. Whenever you're working with unsigned number, overflow flag में कोई issue नहीं है, कोई दिक्कत नहीं है, okay. It would remain as it is. उसमें कोई problem नहीं है. But overflow flag जो basically बना है, it has been designed only to work with signed flag. So signed number पे जब भी आप काम करोगे, signed numbers पे जब भी आप उस पे work करोगे, when you are basically performing operation onto the signed numbers, in that case, only in that case, overflow flag will work. Is it clear? So that is the first point that you should remember. Overflow basically signed numbers के साथ काम में आता है, ना कि unsigned numbers के साथ. Okay, now we'll just try to understand ki basically signed numbers or unsigned numbers kya hai aur iska range kya hota hai. Okay, so basically when we talk about numbers in 8051 mein number kitne bit ka hoga, or the data that you generally use, that data is of, what is the size of that data?
8-bit.
8-bit. The size of the data is generally 8-bit. Okay, so ye jo 8-bit hai, so ye 8-bit kahan se kahan tak vary kar sakta hai? If we talk about the normal डेसिमल नंबर, 8-bit में क्या क्या वैल्यू होगी, कहाँ से कहाँ तक वैरी करेगा?
0 to 255.
So the number that you can think, the number that you can think from 8-bit that can be generated in decimal is 0 to 255. Okay, so basically 0 से लेके 255, it is in which case, signed case or unsigned case?
Unsigned number
की जब बात होगी आपका, वो नंबर कहाँ से वैरी करेगा? 0 से लेके 255 तक. अगर किसी को शक है या समझ में नहीं आ रहा ये नंबर कैसे आया, सो इट केम फ्रॉम, अगर 1-bit का डेटा होगा, 1-bit का अगर डेटा होगा तो उसके पास दो वैल्यू होगी, विच इज 0 and 1. ओके, 2-bit का डेटा होगा तो उसके पास तीन वैल्यू होगी. तीन वैल्यू क्या होगी, चार वैल्यू होगी. वो कौन सी होगी? 0, 0, अगर डेसिमल में बोले तो इसको 0 बोलेंगे, 0, 1 यानी इसको 1 बोलेंगे, 1, 0 यानी इसको 2 बोलेंगे डेसिमल में, या 1, 1 विच इज इक्वल टू 3. सो 2-bit के नंबर कौन सा होगा? 4 नंबर होगा, विच वुड बी 0, 1, 2 and 3. सिमिलरली 3-bit का क्या होगा? इट वुड हैव 8 नंबर्स. वो नंबर क्या होगा? 0 to 7. ओके, सो इट स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 0, 0, 0, इट वुड एड टू 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1 का मतलब 7 हो जाएगा. सिमिलरली 4-bit का कितना हो जाएगा? 2-4, विच इज 16-bit नंबर. ओके, सिमिलरली अगर मेरा 8-bit का डेटा है, सो दैट 8-bit डेटा वुड बी जनरली, इट वुड जनरेट द नंबर फ्रॉम 0 to 2-7. 2-7 इज नथिंग बट 255. सो 0 to 255 इज द रेंज ऑफ माय अनसाइंड नंबर्स. यानी सारे के सारे नंबर अगर मेरे पॉजिटिव होंगे, सो पॉजिटिव नंबर का जो रेंज होगा, दैट वुड बी फ्रॉम 0 to 255. When we talk about signed number, if we talk about signed number, can you tell me what would be the range of the signed numbers?
Yes, 127.
So basically, क्या होगा? इसमें negative number भी होंगे या positive number भी होंगे, बराबर ना? So since the number, since 8-bit के अंदर total 256 number आप store कर सकते हो, तो signed numbers में 256 का half would be stored in negative side and 256 का half will be stored on the positive side. So 256 का exactly half is how much? 256 128. So we'll store 128 numbers in negative side. So we'll start with the minus one. और 128 नंबर मुझे चाहिए तो कितना जाएगा माइनस वन से कहाँ तक जाना पड़ेगा माइनस 128 तक जाना पड़ेगा. सो ऑन द नेगेटिव साइड विल बी हैविंग द नंबर और विल बी हैविंग द रेंज फ्रॉम माइनस वन टू माइनस 128. ओके देन ऑन द पॉजिटिव साइड विल गो फ्रॉम जीरो एंड आपको 128 काउंट करना है बट इट ऑल्सो हैज जीरो इनटू इट. सो व्हाट वुड बी द लास्ट नंबर in positive 127. It would have 127. It would have one value less than the what it supported in the negative side because it also includes zero into it. Zero is considered as positive. Okay, so sign numbers mein it would the range is from minus 128 to minus 1 and in the positive side the range is from 0 to 127. Okay, so that is generally the range. Okay, agar basically when we talk about the processor or the controller, ये जो नंबर है जो आपका डेसिमल है इट इज जनरली दे डोंट यूज द डेसिमल नंबर सिस्टम दे जनरली यूज द हेक्साडेसिमल. सो वी विल जस्ट ट्राई टू कवर वी विल जस्ट ट्राई टू कन्वर्ट दिस रेंज इनटू हेक्साडेसिमल. ओके सो टेल मी द रेंज ऑफ अनसाइंड नंबर्स. अनसाइंड नंबर का रेंज क्या होगा इन हेक्साडेसिमल. इन डेसिमल यू नो राइट डेसिमल में 0 टू 255 है. हेक्साडेसिमल में क्या रेंज होगा 8 बिट जनरली इन हेक्साडेसिमल इन 0 इट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड एज 00H बराबर ना. जीरो वैल्यू को अगर आपको रिप्रेजेंट कराना है इन 8 बिट सो आप क्या लिखोगे 8000000000. सो ये 00 जो आप 80 लिख रहे हो उसको हेक्साडेसिमल में आप कैसे लिखोगे 00H. 255 इन 8 बिट कैन बी रिप्रेजेंटेड एज 81. सो क्या हो जाएगा FFH. सो ये जो रेंज है FFH से लेके 00H के बीच में दिस इज द रेंज ऑफ अनसाइंड नंबर्स. क्लियर विद दैट पार्ट. यहां तक समझ में आ गया.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, next we need to calculate the signed numbers ka range. Signed numbers ka range kya hoga? Signed numbers ka range kya hoga? We'll start with the positive side. We'll start with the positive side. Positive side mein, the number is 00. So, 0 ko generally aap 00H se represent karate. Okay. So, 0 is nothing but 00H. What about 127? 127 can be written down as? 127 can be written down as? 1111111. So kya likha jayega ye? It has 4 ones and this higher level it would be 3 ones. Barabar na? This is nothing but 127. Is it 127?
128.
128 or 127 is this number? How it can be 128? Just take it out. So ये कि कैसे है इसको calculate करो convert करो. So this is nothing but 2 raised to 0 into 1. So it is 1. This is 2. This is 4. This is 8. This is 16. This is 32. This is 64. Just try to add the numbers. Can anybody tell, add the numbers? What would it be? What is the value that you are getting? Is it 127 or 128? I think it would come to 127. 127. Okay. So 127 का मतलब basically अगर इसको मैं hexadecimal में convert करूँ, hexadecimal में क्या होता है? You take the combination of 4 bits. Okay. 4 bits को आप एक उसमें convert करते हो. So this would become what? 011 is nothing but
7.
And this is F.
F.
So the range of the positive side in the positive side was from 00H to 7FH.
7FH.
ठीक है? ये कैसे आया range? समझ में आया आप सबको? It generally came from ये जो नंबर है आपका उसको कन्वर्ट कर दिया आपने hexadecimal में. Okay, so hexadecimal में कन्वर्ट करने it would become 7FH. Okay, what about the in the negative side? Negative side में क्या होगा range? Negative side में it is from minus 1 to minus 128. So generally इसको अगर आप कन्वर्ट करोगे तो नंबर जो है generally signed numbers जो होता है वो directly आप store नहीं करते उसको 2's complement में आप store करते हो. So it would become some other value. It would not be exactly this, but the range is nothing but it would be 7FH. यहाँ पे लिख रहा है तो यहाँ पे कहाँ तक जाएगा? लास्ट इज माइनस 128 बराबर, यानी 127 से एक ज्यादा. इसका मतलब नेगेटिव साइड में इट वुड बी माइनस 80H. इज इट क्लियर? माइनस 80H कैसे आया? हाउ डज द माइनस 80H केम? बिकॉज ऑन द पॉजिटिव साइड अगर आप देखोगे यहाँ पे 127 दिख रहा है आपको. ओके, ओवर हियर यू कैन सी 127. ओवर हियर इन द नेगेटिव साइड इट इज 1 ग्रेटर देन दैट नंबर. So one greater than that number would be generally it is followed in the case of hexadecimal as well. So hexadecimal में 7FH है, उससे एक ज्यादा नंबर क्या होगा? 7FH से एक ज्यादा नंबर क्या होगा? 7F के बाद क्या आता है? 80. So that 80 is over here. That 80 is written down over here. Okay. So this number it generally came from the positive side में से एक नंबर बढ़ा दो तो it would be the max reach of the number in the negative side. And similarly, what would is the lowest number? It is -01H. So -01H से -80H तक जो range है आपका वो negative side में है और positive side में it is the range from 00H to 7FH. Is the range clear to you? Is the range clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now next important thing that I want to explain is so agar now basically what we are doing is we are studying the overflow flag. Okay, so overflow flag mein I have already told you first point is it basically works with sign number. Okay, so agar maine ek number likha jiska naam hai 10110101. Okay, this is my number. Okay, this is my 8 bit number. So by looking at this number, what are the information that you can get? What are the information that you can get or by looking at this number? Can you tell me the value of it? What is the value? The number ki value bata sakte ho? What is this number? What are the information that you can get? Is it a positive number or negative number?
Negative number.
How you have identified?
One.
If the number has MSB is equal to 1, in that case the number is negative. Okay. So number negative है, ये मुझे पहला information मिलेगा. Second information, since the number is negative, क्या मैं उसका original वही value ले लूँगा या उसका 2's complement लूँगा?
2's complement.
I have to take the 2's complement. I cannot blindly take the exactly value. Same वही value मैं नहीं लूँगा. Because as we know, कंप्यूटर के अंदर जो भी आपका नेगेटिव नंबर होगा दैट नेगेटिव नंबर इज ऑलवेज स्टोर्ड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ 2's कॉम्प्लीमेंट. सो 2's कॉम्प्लीमेंट निकालने का सबसे अच्छा तरीका क्या है? वी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द राइट साइड का नंबर से. जब तक आपको पहला 1 नहीं मिल जाता है तब तक आप उस नंबर को कॉपी करते हो. सो सिंस पहले ही आपको 1 मिल गया तो आप उसको वहां तक कॉपी करोगे. उसके आगे के सारे बिट को आप क्या करोगे? फ्लिप कर दोगे. सो दिस 0 विल बिकम 1, दिस 1 विल बिकम 0, दिस 0 विल बिकम 1, this one will become 0, this one will become 0, this 0 will become 1, and this one will become 0. So this number is nothing but, what is this number 0110? What is this number? 4. And this is nothing but 8 plus 2 is 10, 10 plus 1 is 11. 11 is nothing but? 11 is nothing but?
3.
So the number is -4BH. Okay, so the number is -4BH. So you cannot just look at this value. ये value को देख के आप सीधा judge नहीं कर सकते. अगर उसको देख के judge किया होता आपने तो क्या value होती? What would be the value if you have directly judged the values? So ये आपका 8 plus, हाँ, so this would become B and this would become 5. Okay, so आपको जो value आती it would be B5, but it is not B5, it is -4BH. Is it clear? Is the concept clear?
Yeah.
Okay. Now tell me, sorry, I have come to the end of the slide, I will just erase it. So agar maan lo mere paas ek number hai, okay, I've got a number which is called as 7f. 7f ke saath main agar 1 add karta, I want to add 1 to it. So what would be the value that I generate? What is the value that I can generate? After adding 7f to 1, what is the next value that I can get out of 7f? Kya value aayegi?
80.
Barabar na? जैसे 1 के बाद 2 आएगा, 2 के बाद 3 आएगा, 3 के बाद 4 आएगा, 4 के बाद 5 आएगा. सिमिलरली f के बाद 0f के बाद क्या आएगा? 10 आएगा. 10 के बाद 11 आएगा, फिर 12 आएगा, 13 आएगा, 14 आएगा. 1f के बाद 20 आएगा, 20 के बाद 21 आएगा, 22 आएगा, 23 आएगा, 2f तक जाएगा ये. 2f के बाद 30 आएगा. सिमिलरली 7f के बाद क्या आएगा? 80 आएगा. इज इट क्लियर? सो वी जस्ट ट्राई टू डू दिस ऑपरेशन. वी जस्ट ट्राई टू डू दिस ऑपरेशन ऑन टू बाइनरी. सो 7 को आप कैसे ले सकते हो, 0 triple 1. F को यू कैन राइट डाउन एज 1 1 1 1. ओके, सिमिलरली 0 1 कैन बी रिटन डाउन एज 0 0 0 0 एंड 1 कैन बी रिटन डाउन एज 0 0 0 1. ओके, परफॉर्म द एड ऑपरेशन. सो व्हाट वी आर बेसिकली परफॉर्मिंग एड, वी आर एडिंग टू पॉजिटिव नंबर्स. ओके, दीज टू आर पॉजिटिव नंबर्स, राइट, वी आर डीलिंग विद साइन नंबर्स नाउ. सो 1 1 को एड करोगे तो आउटपुट विल बी 0 carry 1. तो 0 carry 1 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 and then 1. Fine, this is what I will get, this is what I should get.
80 yes.
बराबर ना, तो 80 आ गया ना मेरा, मेरा आंसर बराबर है, परफेक्ट है, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. बट एज पर द रूल, एज पर द रूल दैट दैट हैज बीन डिसाइडेड, यानी एमएसबी को देख के आप डिसाइड करोगे साइन होगा, साइन आपका बराबर ना. व्हेनेवर वी लुक एट द एमएसबी इट डिसाइड्स इज साइन. सो बाय लुकिंग एट दिस साइन, इज द नंबर नेगेटिव और पॉजिटिव?
नेगेटिव,
द नंबर इज नेगेटिव. बट कैन यू परफॉर्म, कैन यू गेट अ नेगेटिव नंबर व्हाइल एडिंग टू पॉजिटिव नंबर? कैन यू गेट दैट?
No,
that means whatever this sign is telling me, that is wrong. Okay, so जो sign मुझे बता रहा है, that is wrong. Okay, why it is wrong? Because जो number है आपका, it has been overflown. Okay, because it has gone out of the range. So अगर आप देखोगे 80 जो आपका result था, ये जो 80 है, वो ये जो range है आपका in positive side, which is 7FH, इससे बड़ा हो गया. इससे बड़ा होने के बाद, यानी इससे overflow होने के बाद, अब जो इसका साइन होगा वो गलत बताएगा आपका. सो ओवरफ्लो फ्लैग जो है बेसिकली, इट टेल्स यू कि व्हाटएवर द साइन फ्लैग इज, इफ देयर इज अ ओवरफ्लो, व्हाटएवर द साइन फ्लैग इज टेलिंग यू, दैट साइन फ्लैग और दैट साइन इज अ रॉन्ग साइन. ओके, सो अगर वो पॉजिटिव नंबर बता रहा होगा तो वो नेगेटिव होगा, या अगर वो नेगेटिव बता रहा होगा तो पॉजिटिव होगा. अगर ओवरफ्लो हुआ तो, अगर ओवरफ्लो नहीं है, सो व्हाटएवर इज द साइन, दैट इज द ट्रू साइन ऑफ द नंबर. Is it clear?
Yes.
I'll repeat it again. Overflow flag क्या करता है? Overflow flag. In this case, overflow flag जो है आपका, that would be made as 1. Okay. Why it would be made as 1? Because जो number है आपका, the number is out of, it is out of the range. Range क्या था? 00H to 7FH. So since the number is greater than 7FH, naturally जो number आपका होगा, वो overflow होगा. So overflow flag मुझे क्या बताएगा? Overflow flag will tell me कि whatever is the MSB, whatever the sign which is represented by the MSB, that MSB is not the true sign of the number. Okay, that MSB is the vice versa of the sign that it is showing. So since यहाँ पे अगर आप MSB देखोगे, आपको लगेगा number negative है, but that number is not a negative number. It is a positive number because the number has been overflow. Is it clear to you? So whenever you want to check whether a number is negative or positive, you don't directly blindly follow the MSB. MSB ko dekh ke aap bol nahi sakte. First you need to check what? The content of the overflow flag. Agar overflow flag 0 hota hai, so whatever MSB hai, that is the true sign. Okay? So agar MSB 1 hoga, matlab number negative hai. Agar MSB 0 hoga, number positive hai. Okay? Agar overflow flag agar aapka 1 hota hai, in that case, जो भी आपका MSB होगा वो उसका साइन नहीं होगा, उसका वाइस वर्सा वुड बी साइन. सो अगर MSB 1 होगा, इन दैट केस द नंबर इज नॉट नेगेटिव बट इट विल बी पॉजिटिव. अगर MSB 0 होगा, दैट मींस द नंबर इज नॉट पॉजिटिव, इट इज नेगेटिव. इज इट क्लियर? इज ओवरफ्लो फ्लैग क्लियर टू यू?
यस सर.
ओके, सो दैट इज ऑल रिलेटेड टू ओवरफ्लो फ्लैग. वी विल जस्ट टेक फ्यू एग्जांपल्स. ओके, वी विल जस्ट टेक फ्यू एग्जांपल्स बिफोर स्टार्टिंग विद द next part. Okay, so next jo aapka RS0 RS1 wo sab bacha hai, what can you tell me what is exact time right now?
26.
So we have got how many time? 20 minute ke kareeb bacha hai na. Ha, 20 minute bacha hai mere paas. Okay, so we'll just take few example and you just tell me what are the values that is being generated, or what are the flag that is being generated. Okay, so please do the operation on your own. So I've got a number 35H plus 22H. This is the number that I've got. इनको ऐड करना है. ओके सो व्हाट वुड बी द रिजल्ट दैट आई वुड बी जनरेटेड आउट ऑफ इट. रिजल्ट क्या आएगा, 5 प्लस 2 विल बी 7, 3 प्लस 2 वुड बी 3 प्लस 2 वुड बी 5. सो रिजल्ट क्या आएगा, 57 H. ओके सो विल जस्ट ट्राई टू परफॉर्म दिस ऑपरेशन इन बाइनरी एंड चेक वेदर विल बी गेटिंग द सेम आंसर. सो क्या आएगा, 3 कैन बी रिटन डाउन एज 0011, 5 कैन बी रिटन डाउन एज, से इट लाउडली, 5 कैन बी रिटन डाउन एज 0101. Over here, 2 can be written down as 0010, and then 2 can be written down as 0010. Okay, perform the AND operation. 1 plus 0 is 1, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 0 is 1, 0 plus 0 is 0, 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1, this is 1, this is 0. Okay, so are we getting 57? Yes, we are getting 57. Now tell me, after looking this result, tell me the content of carry flag, tell me the content of auxiliary carry flag, tell me the content of parity flag, and tell me the content of overflow flag. What is the value of carry flag? 0 and 1.
0.
0.
0.
What about auxiliary carry?
0.
0.
0. What about parity? Odd parity, even
1.
Odd parity, even parity.
Odd.
1.
So 1 ho jayega. Overflow flag. Overflow flag, is it out of the range or is it within the range?
Within the range.
7f se chota hai ya 7f se bada hai? It is chota, right? 7f se chota hai. So that means it is within the range. So overflow flag overflow hoga ki nahi hoga?
Nahi hoga, 0.
Nahi hoga.
Is it clear? Now perform the next operation, which is 42 plus 43. Perform the operation, perform the AND operation, add operation. So result kya aega? 585H aega. Okay, so perform the operation in binary. So 4 can be written down as 0100, 2 can be written down as 0010. Over here 4 can be written down as again 0100, 3 can be written down as 0011. Perform the addition. So 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 1 is 0, carry 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. The row carry one. Okay, so this is what I get, which is nothing but 85. Barabar na? So tell me the carry flag. Tell me the auxiliary carry.
Zero.
Tell me the parity. Tell me the overflow. So carry will be, carry kya hoga? Zero. Carry is zero because there is no carry which is generated out of MSB. Say koi carry generate nahi ho raha. Okay. So till now there is no carry which is generated out of MSB. So that is why carry will be made at zero. What about auxiliary carry? निबल से कैरी कोई जनरेट हो रहा है? नो. सो दैट मींस इट विल बी अगेन
जीरो.
व्हाट अबाउट पैरिटी?
वन.
इट इज वन. व्हाट अबाउट ओवरफ्लो फ्लैग?
वन.
इट वुड बी वन बिकॉज़ द रेंज जो है आपका इट इज ग्रेटर देन 7fh. द नंबर इज ओवरफ्लो. सो कैन यू टेल मी बाय लुकिंग एट दिस नंबर, कैन यू एग्जैक्टली टेल मी बाय विदाउट लुकिंग एट ओवरफ्लो, कैन यू टेल मी इज इट पॉजिटिव नंबर और नेगेटिव नंबर? If you don't look at the overflow number, overflow flag, अगर आप overflow flag नहीं देखते हो, अगर overflow flag नहीं देखते हो, आपको देख के क्या लगेगा? Number जो है negative number है. But अगर आप overflow flag देखते हो, overflow flag में क्या लिखा है? Number is overflown. Because the number of is overflown, that means whatever is the MSB, उसका vice versa is my sign. So if my MSB is 1, that means the number should be negative. But because it has been overflown, the number should be
positive.
Okay, so the conclusion that I can make is the number is positive. Fine. I will take another example. Last example, main le leta hu. Okay. Just I will erase it. So because aap log ne 8086 already maine aapko padhaya hua hai. Okay. So I think you are familiar more than familiar enough. So thoda sa difficulty level mein badha deta hu. Aur mujhe aap batao kya hoga. Okay. I will just erase it. So the next number that I want to perform is minus 37H add with minus, let's say, 62H. Perform the operation and tell me the value. Do it on your own first. I will not be doing this operation. Just do the value and tell me. the carry flag, auxiliary carry flag, the parity and overflow. Okay, tell me the values for it. Do it first. How to do this? कैसे करेंगे? सबसे पहले 37 को माइनस 37 को बाइनरी में लिखना पड़ेगा. How to write down minus 37 in binary? How to write down minus 37 as binary? Has anybody got the value of minus 37? कैसे निकालना है? कोई बता सकता है?
Since the number complement.
Two's complement. Okay, so first, since the number is negative, that means it should be written down in its two's complement form. So two's complement में basically 37 का two's complement निकालना पड़ेगा. 37 can be written down as first find out the value of 37 in binary. 37 कैसे लिखोगे आप? So 32 bit one यानी आपका basically fifth bit should be no sorry sixth bit should be one, which is 32. Then इसके बाद zero, then we have got 32 plus 8 would become 40, so again zero, then 4 वाला, okay, 32 plus 4 I can make, 32 plus 4 is 36, 37, 38, 0, 1. Are you getting this value? 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1. Is this the value that you got? 37 यही है ना?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So minus 37 अगर मेरे को बनाना पड़ेगा इस नंबर को, मेरे को minus 37 बनाना होगा तो मैं क्या करूँगा? इसका two's complement लूँगा. So two's complement again, how to take two's complement? We start from the right side till we get the first one. तब तक मुझे copy करना है. So first one मुझे पहली place पे मिल जाएगा, वहाँ तक मैंने copy कर दिया. इसके आगे के सारे bit को मुझे flip करना पड़ेगा. So flip the next bit. So zero will become one, one will become zero. This zero will become one. This zero will become one. This one will become zero. This zero will become one. This one will become one. So what are the value of minus 37? Minus 37 can be written down as 1101 and 1011. This is the value of minus 37. Similarly, what is the value of minus 62? Anybody got the value of minus 62? Minus 62 ka value aya? So minus 62 can be written down as first 62 ko binary mein likho. तो बाइनरी में क्या रिप्रेजेंटेशन होगा? तो 32 प्लस 16 प्लस हैज एनीबडी कैलकुलेटेड द वैल्यू ऑफ 62? माइनस 62 का वैल्यू आया किसी का? Are you able to solve it out? या मुझे करना पड़ेगा? Okay, कोई response नहीं आ रहा, इसका मतलब मेरे को करने के लिए बोल रहा हूँ basically. So 32 plus 16 plus 62 plus is 8, 8 plus 1 is 4. Then next is I will add 8 to it, so this would become 56. 56 plus 4, it would become 60.
जीरो जीरो वन वन,
सो ये हो जाएगा वन वन, देन
वन 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 जीरो
वन वन जीरो, ओके, सो जीरो जीरो वन 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 जीरो, ओके, सो दिस इज़ द नंबर दैट आई गेट 62, इसको मेरे को नेगेटिव में कन्वर्ट करना है, सो मैंने क्या बोला था, राइट हैंड से आप स्टार्ट करते हैं, ओके, सो राइट हैंड साइड से आप स्टार्ट करते हो, जब तक आपको फर्स्ट वन नहीं मिलता तब तक आप उस नंबर को कॉपी करते हो. सो जीरो आई डिड नॉट गेट माय फर्स्ट वन, सो मैं कॉपी कर लूंगा जीरो का एज इट इज. वन मुझे मिला, मैंने मेरा फर्स्ट वन मिल गया, मैंने उसको कॉपी कर लिया. उसके आगे के सारे बिट को मुझे फ्लिप करना है. सो दिस वन विल बिकम जीरो, 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 दिस जीरो विल बिकम वन, दिस जीरो विल बिकम वन. सो आई पुट डाउन द वैल्यू, सो वैल्यू क्या हो जाएगा? वन वन जीरो जीरो, ओके, ओवर हियर इट वुड बिकम जीरो 0, 1, 0. Perform the addition operation between it. So addition करके क्या मिलेगा आपको? We'll get 1. 1, 1 is 0. Carry 1. We'll get 1 over here. Then 1. Then 1, 0, 0. Carry 1. and then what you'll get over here? 1 plus 1 plus 1 is what? 1 and
1.
1 and carry 1. Fine? Is it clear? So this is what the data that I generally get. So ये data को देख के आपको बताना है कि number negative है कि positive है या इसका carry क्या है या auxiliary carry क्या है या parity क्या है. So first tell me what is the carry flag? Carry flag क्या होगा?
One.
Because it is generating a carry, so naturally carry flag would become one. Okay. What about auxiliary carry? Is there any auxiliary carry which is generated? यानी lower nibble यानी ये वाले part में कोई carry generate हुआ है आपका? नहीं. Auxiliary carry is zero. What about parity? Count the number of ones. Is it odd or even? So 2 plus 3, 5. So क्या होगा?
Odd.
One.
Odd parity is 1 or 0?
1.
Odd is 1. Okay. Now tell me about overflow. Overflow है कि नहीं? Is it overflow or is it not overflow? How to check that? पहले क्या करोगे आप? ये number को उसके true form में convert करोगे. Okay. So how to convert it? जनरली यहाँ यहीं से देख लो ना क्या हो जाएगा. 7 प्लस 2 इज व्हाट? 9. 3 प्लस 6 इज व्हाट? 9. सो द नंबर इज -99h. ओके, सो -99h इज इट आउट ऑफ -88h? इट इज आउट ऑफ -88h. सो व्हाटएवर इज माय ओवरफ्लो फ्लैग इज नथिंग बट इट वुड बी 1 बिकॉज़ द नंबर इज बीन आउट ऑफ द रेंज. सो -88h से ज्यादा है ये. ओके, ज्यादा छोटा नंबर है. सो दैट इज व्हाई इट इज आउट ऑफ द रेंज. सो ओवरफ्लो फ्लैग विल बी 1. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what we'll do, we'll try to cover up the next part of the flag and we'll just wind up this session. So abhi jo next hai aapka flag, the next flag is called as user defined flag. FO is called as user defined flag. Okay. So just write down over there in FO. Just write down it is user defined flag. ओके, सो एफओ का मतलब क्या है? यूजर डिफाइंड फ्लैग. यूजर डिफाइंड का मतलब क्या होगा? यूजर जो चाहे उसके अंदर डाले. ओके, सो यूजर उसको अपनी मर्जी के लिए कहीं पे भी यूज कर सकता है. ओके, सो यूजर कैन मेक गिव यूज दिस फ्लैग बेसिकली फॉर आइडेंटिफाइंग वेदर फैन इज ऑन या ऑफ. ओके, लाइट इज ऑन या ऑफ. सो ये जो है यूजर डिफाइन करेगा. यूजर अपनी मर्जी से इसको यूज कर सकता है एज अ वेरिएबल. ओके, सो इसके अंदर जो भी वैल्यू उसको डालना है वो उसके अंदर बड़े आसानी से डाल सकता है. Fine. Is it clear? So it does not have any impact on, does not have any implication on what is the status that you're working. Okay. So status के ऊपर कुछ लेना देना नहीं है. It is user defined. It is basically reserved for the user only. So user ही इसको use करेगा. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
तो अगर user को इसको मान लो one करना है, इस flag को one करना है, तो it could perform one by using an instruction called as setB. ओके, सेट बी यानी सेट द बिट. और अगर इसको जीरो करना है तो इट वुड परफॉर्म द ऑपरेशन कॉल्ड एज क्लियर. ओके, इट वुड परफॉर्म द क्लियर ऑपरेशन. और इस बिट को आइडेंटिफाई कैसे करोगे? सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज PSW 0.0. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज PSW 0.1. सो सिमिलरली दिस बिट विल बी कॉल्ड एज PSW 0.5. सो इफ आई राइट सेट बी PSW 0.5, इसका मतलब ये क्या करेगा? F0 को या FO को क्या कर देगा? FO को वो सेट कर देगा. इफ आई राइट CLR PSW 0.5, इट विल क्लियर द यूजर डिफाइंड फ्लैग. इज इट क्लियर? समझ में आया यूजर डिफाइंड का मतलब?
यस सर.
सो यूजर अपने हिसाब से, अपने प्रोग्राम के हिसाब से, जैसा उसको मर्जी आए उस फ्लैग को अपने अपने हिसाब से उसको चेंज कर सकता है. ओके, सो दैट इज अप टू यूजर. Next is the most important part of the flag, which is very new to you. This are called as RS1 and RS0. Okay, so these are called as registered bank slip. Okay, so these are called, or these flag basically are called as registered bank select. Registered bank select. Okay, so ye basically select karta hai ki aap kis bank ke liye kaam kar rahe ho. Okay, whether you're working in bank 0, bank 1, bank 2. ओके, सो बेसिकली अगर अभी जो है आपका 8086 है, अभी फिलहाल टाइम नहीं है हमारे पास. आई विल जस्ट लीव दिस टॉपिक फॉर द नेक्स्ट क्लास. बट जाने से पहले सिर्फ इतना बता देता हूँ कि 8086 जो है आपका, ओके, सो 8051 जो है आपका, 8051 का जो आपका इंटरनल रैम जो होता है, ओके, इंटरनल रैम हैज 32 register into it. Okay, so general purpose register ke liye, how many register it has? It has got 32 registers into it. So starting from R0, okay, R0 से start होता है और कहाँ तक जाएगा? 32 है तो कितना जाएगा? Last would be R31. No, it is not R31. ये R0 से start होगा. Next is R1. Next is R2. And then it will go up till R7. R7 तक जाएगा. Okay, last register would be R7. Then it would again go to the next register. Next register would be again R0. It will go up till R7. Okay, this is second bank. Then R0 से start होगा, फिर R7 तक जाएगा. That would be third bank. So ऐसा कितना 32 register में कितने bank possible है?
Four.
Bank is possible four. So I've got bank zero, I've got bank one, I've got bank two, then I've got bank three. तो ये bank zero क्या होगा? Bank zero के अंदर R0 से R7 register होंगे. Bank one के अंदर भी R0 से R7 होंगे. Bank two के अंदर भी R0 से R7 होंगे. Bank three के अंदर भी R0 से R7 register होंगे. So if I perform the operation, let's say मैं अगर एक operation कर रहा हूँ, which is move A, R0. If I performing the operation called as move A, R0. So ये R0 कौन सा bank का होगा? Will it be bank 0, bank 1, bank 2 या bank 3? किस कौन से bank का होगा?
Bank 0.
आपने explicitly अभी तक define नहीं किया. You have not explicitly defined. R0 is present in all the banks, right? हर एक bank के अंदर same register है, which is R0 to R7. बराबर? So ये जो आपका definition है, ये जो आपका आपको बताना है कि which bank is currently active, that is decided by RS1 and RS0. So अगर आपको bank 0 को activate करना है, so I will just write down the truth table over here. So please write down the truth table, RS1 and RS0. So if the content of RS1 is 0 and it is 0, in that case bank 0 is selected. Okay, if RS1 is 0 and RS0 is 1, in that case bank 1 is selected. If it is 1 and this is 0, in that case bank 2 is selected. And if both are if both are 1, in that case bank 3 is selected. Is it clear? Draw this truth table, and it is important. I will explain it in the next class. Is it clear? जहाँ तक मेरे ख्याल से जिन्होंने अगर थोड़ा ध्यान दिया होगा उनको ऑलरेडी समझ में आ गया होगा, नेक्स्ट क्लास की जरूरत नहीं होगी. सो इफ आई वांट टू परफॉर्म ए मूव A, R0, अगर मुझे ये ऑपरेशन करना है, ये करने से पहले मेरे को बैंक को एक्टिवेट करना पड़ेगा. सो इफ आई लेट्स से मैंने RS1 को भी सेट कर दिया और RS0 को भी सेट बी से उसको सेट कर दिया, सो विच बैंक हैव आई सेलेक्टेड?
बैंक 3.
सो जो R0 होगा वो कौन से बैंक से जाएगा? बैंक 0 से, बैंक 1 से, बैंक 2 से या बैंक 3 से?
बैंक 3 से.
अगर मैंने मान लो RS1 को क्लियर कर दिया और RS0 को सेट कर दिया, विच बैंक आई हैव सिलेक्टेड?
बैंक 1.
सो बैंक 1 से R0 का वैल्यू जाएगा A के अंदर. लेट्स अज्यूम मैंने RS1 को भी क्लियर कर दिया, RS0 को भी क्लियर कर दिया, सो विच बैंक इज बीन सिलेक्टेड नाउ?
Bank 0.
Okay, so bank 0 से जो R0 की वैल्यू रहेगी, that would be gone. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. In short, hardly मेरे ख्याल से time हो चुका है. I will just try to cover up within a minute the whole PSW register. So PSW का full form क्या है? Program status word. Program status word is a 8-bit register, that is very important. Okay. एक और point लिख दो अपने एक line में वहाँ पे. These are bit addressable. Okay, just write it down over there in one line. It is important. The program status word are bit addressable. Bit addressable का मतलब क्या होता है कि हर एक bit को आप address कर सकते हो. Okay, so over here the address is generally PSW.0 to PSW.7. यानी हर एक bit को आप address कर सकते हो. Okay, इसका मतलब user अपने हिसाब से कोई भी flag को change कर सकता है. User have got a user can also change it. In case of 8086, we don't have that feature. Okay, हम वो change नहीं कर सकते थे. Processor खुद value generate करता था और वो flag को change कर सकता था. But यहाँ पे user को explicitly उनको दिया गया है feature ताकि वो change कर सके, ताकि वो bank को select कर सके, ताकि user defined flag को change कर सकते. Okay, so ये basically ये जो तीन flag है आपका F0, RS1 और RS0, इसको change करने के लिए ये पूरे के पूरे register को आपने bit addressable बना दिया. Okay. So user कोई भी flag के साथ खिलवाड़ कर सकता है. Okay, it is up to the user. So we'll start with the first flag. The first flag that it has is called as a carry flag. Carry flag is nothing but it is a flag which will check whether MSB has a carry generated out of it. If there is a carry generated out of the MSB, in that case, the carry flag will be made as 1. Else, it would be made as 0. So that is all related to carry flag. Next, we have got auxiliary carry flag. Auxiliary carry flag mein kya hoga? If there is a carry which is generated out of the lower nibble, in that case, the auxiliary carry flag would be made as 1. Else, it would be made as 0. Then we have got a parity flag. Parity flag will check the count of 1s. If the count of the 1s in the result is odd, in that case, it would be odd parity and the parity flag would be made as 1. If the count of number of 1s in the result is even, then it will be called as an even parity, and even parity has the parity flag of 0.
Zero.
Then we have got a flag which is called as don't care. Don't care ka matlab, whatever the value is in it, it does not care about it. Okay. So, aapko store karna hai, nahi store karna hai, kuch bhi dalna hai, nahi dalna hai, wo aapke upar. Next, we have got another flag which is called as overflow flag. Overflow flag is one of the most important flag which help you to work with only which type of number, signed or unsigned. It is relevant in only which case, signed case or unsigned? Relevant only in case of signed number. Okay, when you're working with unsigned number, you don't have to check at the, you don't have to look into the overflow flag. Jab aap signed number ke sath work karoge, tabhi aapko overflow flag dekhna padega. So what does overflow flag tell you? Overflow flag tells me whether my sign is correct or it is wrong. Okay, if the content of overflow flag is made as 1, if the number is overflown, in that case, whatever my sign is, that is not the true sign, it is the vice versa of the sign. If the content of overflow flag is made as 0, in that case, whatever is my sign, that is my true sign. Is it clear? So it tells me what is my exactly sign of the sign number. Then we have got two more bits in the register, which is called as RS1 and RS0. These are called as register bank select. It selects the bank that you're currently active, your current active bank. So in internal RAM, we have got 128 byte. Those 128 byte message, 32 bytes are basically reserved for your general purpose register. So R0 se R31 tak hona chahiye tha. Lekin hum kya karte hain? Isko R0 se R7 mein hum 4 bank mein divide kar dete hain. Ye kya hai iske piche philosophy? We'll discuss in the next class, okay? When we'll go to the memory organization part. So hum 4 bank mein isko divide karte hain. Currently, kaun sa bank active hai? It all depends on the content of RS1 and RS0. If RS1 and RS0 both are made as 1, in that case, bank 3 is activated. If both are made as 0, in that case, bank 0 is activated. If RS1 is made as 1 and RS0 is made as 0, in that case, which bank is activated?
Bank 2.
Bank 2. If RS1 is 0 and RS0 is 1, in that case, bank 1 is activated. Okay. So whichever bank is activated, the respective registers ranging from R0 to R7 will be used for performing the operation. So that selection of the bank will be done by the registered bank select, which is the pin number RS1 and RS0. Then we have got another flag, which is called as F0. F0 is nothing but it is called as a user defined flag. So user has the full authority over it. So user ko jo value is in the dalna hai, agar set karna hai, toh operation is set B, PS0.5. Clear karna hai, toh clear is CLR, PS0.5. So isse wo set kar sakta, reset kar sakta. It is dependent on the user. Is the program status word clear to you?
Yes. Okay.
Does anybody has any doubt? Anybody has any doubt? Kisi ko kuch puchna hai? Sorry for taking your 5 minutes extra. Okay. So thank you guys. Thank you so much. Maine kal ka lecture upload nahi kiya tha because kal internet connectivity nahi tha. I will try to upload both the lectures, yesterday wala aur aaj ka. So agar kisi ko problem hai, please you can refer that lecture. Okay. Thank you guys. Thank you so much. You can leave now. If anybody has any doubt, they can stay behind and can ask you if they have any doubt.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, sure. Thank you. Thank you.